Everybody, welcome to World 101 Podcast. I am your host, the with the most, Eddie V, the Chocolate Dunder with Wonder. Joining me is my man, the Red Velvet Cake himself, the Nordic Beast, Big Papa Larry Giver.
What up, minions?
And the marvelous Mexicano himself, Mr. Adrian Nieto.
Hello, everyone. Happy to be back.
Yay! How you guys doing?
Can we call Adrian the Emperor of Indy now?
Sure, I'll take it.
Yeah, okay. He is the Emperor of Indie. and so guys, this episode is going to be an indie explosion. We're going to be talking a lot about indie games. All three going to come with one review each for a particular indie game of our choice. One preview, like talking about the game, and then one game that we're all looking forward to. So I'm actually going to start with you, Adrian. Let's start with your preview. What game would you like to preview for your indie?
So recently I was listening to the IGN UK podcast, and I think it was like two, maybe three episodes ago. They talk about something that happens in Sweden called Stugan. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's basically like an indie game development camp, if you can imagine that. So what you do is you basically apply. You can apply as yourself or you can apply as a team. You pitch an idea. It has to be, of course, you have to impress the people that run the program. And you just fly to Sweden for like 2 months, and you have a place to live, and you have food taken care of you, and you live in like a cabin in the woods, basically, with a beautiful lake where you can just go and swim, and you're surrounded by people that are also game developers, indie game developers, super talented people, and just spend 2 months basically making your game. That's a brilliant idea. So I was checking the submissions for 2016 Stugan, and there was a little game that kind of caught my attention a lot, which is called Secret Legend, I believe that's the name. And it's kind of like a Zelda-inspired game on which you take the role of like a teeny tiny, I don't know, like fox, and you explore. And you just imagine like if Link was a fox, and it's like an isometric view type thing, very beautiful art style. And it's just like, I think like how the first Zelda will look like if it was made today. And it's just like, it looks fantastic, honestly. You fight monsters, you collect treasures, you solve puzzles. It's just like a beautiful looking game all around. So Secret Legend, it was presented at PAX this year. And it doesn't have a release date right now, but you can view many previews on YouTube right now. So definitely go and check that out.
All right. And Larry, what's your preview? What game would you like to preview?
First of all, Adrian, have you got your application in for this camp yet?
No, because the camp already happened this year. Application for next haven't started yet, but I'm keeping my eye out because I will pretty much love to apply to this program. I think it's excellent, and I would love to meet a bunch of like really talented game developers. I've never been camping, so... You know, like cross two experience at once. I think that would be great. So,
right on.
Oh, nice.
Not gonna lie, I totally don't have anything indie really on my radar at this point. Most of the stuff that I've really been watching and itching for came out over the last couple months. You know, Armacrog is out. Axiom is finally on the Wii U. Got AM2R. Oh my god. More AM2R. But yeah, my indie plate is a little empty at the moment, at least looking forward. You know, right now I've had so much that I'm still working on the ass end of Armacrog, which I swear I'm maybe less than an hour away from finishing at this point, and Axiom, which I am nowhere near finishing, which is a travesty in its own right. But so yeah.
Okay. My game that I'd like to preview is Hollow Knight by Team Cherry. It's a monochrome looking game, action platform. It kind of is like a modern Shovel Knight, but very dark. Beautiful animation. I think it's going to have a Metroidvania feel to it, and the attacks are really cool. I'm like, it looks very beautiful. Nintendo showed it for their summer games for the Nindies. So it's coming out, I think, like later on this year. And that's one game that, it just looks very beautiful. You can check out the trailer on YouTube. It's called Hollow Knight, once again, by Team Cherry. Larry, let's talk about our indie reviews. What game would you like to speak about? Like, would you like to give your review?
I already reviewed the hell out of AM2R because it's amazing. And for those that haven't played it, you need to do a little hunting and find it. Because reasons. Beyond that, I will say, like I said, I'm at the tail end of Armacrog at this point. And having delved a little further in, I'm going to retract my initial statement on the fact that some of the puzzles didn't seem to have a logic to them. Mm-hmm. Like, it felt like you had to brute force it. And I'm looking back now at some of those and going, oh, there was the logic. I just fucking missed it. But so I'm happier with that now than I was initially. At this point, the only thing that makes me sad is that I know it's almost over. But for the less than $10 that I spent on it, I don't feel like, you know, I got gypped or anything. I certainly got my money's worth out of it. The art style is a wonderful trip back to my childhood. The Neverhood was one of my first and favorite PC games ever. It's still, in my opinion, one of the best point-and-click adventure games ever made, standing proud alongside the Journeyman Project series, which one day we'll talk about all those because those are great too. But the humor in it is wonderful. It's still got that same adorable, quirky humor that the Neverhood folks have dialed in so well. It's absolutely worth a buy at this point. It's, like I said, it's maybe $10 pretty much anywhere. It's on, I think, like every platform at this point. Mm-hmm. So there's no excuse not to play it. But I will say, if you have a Wii U, I would play it there, because playing it with the gamepad makes it a lot more manageable when you can use the stylus and the touchpad in conjunction with the thumbstick.
Oh, great.
This was a Kickstarter game, am I right?
What was that?
This was a Kickstarter game, right?
It was.
Did you back it, or?
I didn't. My funds for a while and my general take on Kickstarter kind of went south a long time ago. I'll look at things and go, ah, that's neat. Mental note, check that out if it ever makes it out.
Gotcha. So, yeah, I was just a little, like, it's my kind of game. I mean, it is, but to some, like I'm into some of those games, but not into every single one of them. And I was checking some, like, gameplays and stuff like that, and it looks fun, it looks alright. I feel like, what, like, $10 on the, something like that?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta repeat that. You're, I think you and Eddie are both in the bucket.
We are? Oh, no.
It might be my connection, but, you know, technical issues apparently are now our running joke.
Yeah, sure. No, I was just saying that, hold on. Eddie, are you, like, listening, hearing me okay, or?
Yeah, you're, like, cracking it up a little bit, but you are coming through just crackling.
Okay. I was just saying, and asking, hey, like, if is the game, like, $10 or something on Wii U, right?
Yeah, like you said, I spent like $9 or $10 on it. It's not expensive at all. You'll definitely get your $9 or $10 worth out of it. Okay. It's well worth. I can't give a reason not to get it at this point, having played as much of it as I have. this point, I just need to finish pushing through to the end of it and see how the whole thing wraps up. Part of me is really, really hoping at least just for one loose thread connection to Neverhood, but I haven't seen it yet. It's like, come on, just one. You know, it is a point-and-click adventure game, but it doesn't have the length and the breadth of an old-school point-and-click adventure game. Like, this is something that, you know, was designed on a much smaller budget. It seems like it was designed to be a lot more easily digestible. Like, they didn't want it to trudge on forever. They wanted people to be able to finish it before their attention spans ran out. And for that, you know, as much as it makes me personally sad, I get it, because that's kind of the direction a lot of things have headed. And it was a smart thing for them to do.
All right, cool. Well, $10 is not that high of an asking price. I might check it out for sure, especially on Wii U.
Yeah, I would.
I definitely need to buy it, because there's a lot of Wii U games, indie games that I'm buying, and Armored Core is one game that I definitely want to buy. So Adrian, what game would you like to review?
So, I was kind of confused about this part a little bit, so I didn't know what to do properly. But, like, when you said one game to review, was it, like, one game that was reviewed by someone else and I'm bringing to the table because to review?
Any indie game that you would like to review is all up to you.
Oh, that I would like personally? Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm just going for the same one that I had already anyway. So Jotun, I don't know how to pronounce it properly. Valhalla Edition just came out for Wii U a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, yes, I want to
get it. It has an 81.
Yeah, that was last week's.
Yeah. Oh, I want to hear about this because I need to buy it. This is one of the games that I want to buy. Animation looks amazing.
It looks so pretty.
Yeah, it looks just incredibly and amazing. I think it's all hand-drawn. Like animations and environments and stuff like that. So, like, props to the developer, really. It has 81 Metacritic for the Wii U version, which is really good. If a game has, like, over 80, it's considered a really good game. But it's kind of like a 2D, like, Dark Souls-y type game, where you fight really big things and anything can go south, like, incredibly fast. So you're these... you're this warrior who, like, can die a shameful death, and you're trying to, you know, basically make peace with the gods and, like, recover your honor by battling all these different monsters and bosses and stuff like that in the throughout the game. I haven't put too much time into it. Sadly, I missed the sale that was originally when the game came out. I think it was, like, 10% or something off the first week. I missed that, sadly, but... still totally worth it. The game is fantastic and it's really fun. So, it has my seal of approval. Like, go and buy it. It's, if you like Dark Souls and if you like really like interesting boss battles, just go ahead and play it for a bit.
Now, is it kind of like the top views like a Zelda game, or is it straight like top views Dark Souls?
No. Well, Dark Souls is a third-person game.
Dark Souls in a way that when you die, you got to restart, and it kind of gets harder and harder. Like it, top down is just it's the view, but it's like a Dark Souls game, like in its formula.
Yeah, exactly. It's not that it gets harder. It's just like you die and you have to like it's. It's not even like in the Dark Souls way where like everything responds. It's just like you die because the boss battle was really hard, but all you have to do is just like read it properly, like a Dark Souls game. If you read the boss properly, Dark Souls is not hard. It just all comes down to your ability of like reading and reacting on time. And that's basically what this game is. It's not a hard game. It's just how well are you with patterns and like boss mechanics and stuff like that. And just dodging on time, right? Like that's pretty much all there is about. The perspective, like I said, it's not really top down. It's more like a 2.5D side.
Well, the reason why I say top down is the way that when you look at the trailer, all they've been showing us top down. Just for the way that they've been showing it in the trailer. So that's why I was asking. asking it.
Yeah, no, no. It's more like a 2.5D, I guess, to some extent. But no, yeah, it's a fantastic game. So just go and play it, I guess. Just buy it. I think it's like $15 on Wii U right now.
I think so. Yeah.
It's on the high end of indie games, but $15 is totally worth for this game.
All right.
You're going to have tons of fun, and it's just like a beautiful looking game. So, I mean, what other excuse do you have?
And for my review, everybody, I'm going to review Dust, the Legion Tale. It's on PS4. I think Xbox 360 is on. I don't know if it's on PS3. It might be. But the version I played was PS4. If you have played Muramasa, the Demon Blade, and what's the other one? The same company who made Muramasa Demon Blade, Otosphere. If you play something like that, it plays a little bit like that. It's kind of a RPG beat-em-up, hack and slash kind of game. Beautiful art style, funny story with voice acting, kind of dark at times, and it has a Metroidvania style to it. Different areas that you go to collect new powers and new weapons. It does get tough at times, so be ready for that. But they have where you could buy rubies to revive you if you lose all your energy. You could collect food. You can't collect different weapons. You only could collect like different powers for your sprite that help that kind of helps you, your assistant that helps you throughout the adventure. You have a blade that talks. You could do kind of like rebound and dodging. So the rebound part is like when they attack you, if you hit your attack button at the same time, there's like a slow kind of cling, and it'll show you in slow motion that your enemy is falling back and you falling a little back, and they would be stunned and you go and attack them. And then you could like dodge really far left or to the right. And then they also have like the special kind of spin move where with your blade, you'll spin it, rotating to juggle enemies in the air. And when you throw your sprite's firepower or special ability with it, it makes a big special attack. And you could do it only for a limited time because it turns your body red. Once it hits red, you'll lose actually energy and it'll knock you out. So you do have to make sure how your character is turning. Like I said, 2.5, not 2.5, mostly a 2D game. It has side quests, it's, hidden areas, chests. Not too many puzzles is in this. You just explore, beat stuff up and gain levels. When you gain levels, you do, make your character get stronger. You have the decision of doing their attack, their health bar, their defense, or you can help your assistant Fidget get stronger. And if you help Fidget get stronger, he allows you to get stronger with your energy, your defense, and with your attack. So do be aware of that. So that's kind of where the RPG mechanic, every time you get a level, you'll be able to level that stuff up. It has alchemy in it where you get a blueprint and you got to get materials together and deliver them to someone to fix it. They'll make that item for you and then you'll be able to get on. Most of the time you could just buy the outfit like or equipment right out, or you could save up and get those materials and just pay a cheaper price to get them built. To me, this game is a 4 out of 5 Yoshi coins. I definitely do recommend it. If you have a 360, purchase the game. If you have a PS4, it's still a good game to get. So that's a 4.5.
It's also on PC as well. So if you have a Steam, you can buy it there.
Yeah, awesome. The game that I'm actually looking forward to, like I said, Nintendo did their Nindies, like about 20 games is coming out for the end of the year, and I think maybe a little bit next year. The one that I'm looking definitely forward to is this week is Severed, the guys who made game. Which one? Oh, Guacamelee. Yeah, this game is on PS, on Vita. That's what it's on. But they're bringing it to the Wii U and I believe the 3DS also. It's kind of, I want to say somewhat hack and slash, but first person. You'll be using your stylus. The art style looks beautiful. It looks like a great adventure. It got great reviews on the Vita. So I think it's going to work, wonders and probably have improvements on the Wii U edition. It's supposed to be out this Thursday for, the 10% discount. So if you are interested, do check it out. But that's the game that I'm looking forward to. What about you, Adrian?
So when you said, and this, I got confused here again. I thought it was like a game that was out and just like for people to get right now.
Any game that you're looking forward to buy that you want to recommend or that you're just looking forward to own.
The game that I would recommend, really, it's the only game that matters. It's Shovel Knight, because that's the only game that matters. No, I'm joking. I actually finished Oxenfree, and we talked a little bit about Oxenfree on one of our earliest Indie Watch. But I finished it recently. It's very short. It's only like 4 hours. It's a very creepy story. So if you're looking for like a very simple game to play during Halloween, totally go and check that out, because it's a fantastic, very simple and quick game that has multiple endings. So free play value right there, and I think it's only like 15, 20 bucks, so it's not expensive at all. Yeah. So totally worth
it. Yeah, I have it on my Xbox One. I need to get back into it. It looks very interesting.
Yeah, it gets super creepy super fast as well. So, Larry was kind of like talking about like adventure point and click games. This is very much like a new take on adventure point and click adventure games. Kind of like old school, but also kind of using the Telltale formula to some extent, but in like very interesting ways.
Very so like dialogue based.
Sorry?
Dialogue based, like you choose a lot of dialogues to get the action, to like the next thing that happens.
Yeah, pretty much. But it's not as unforgiving as any of the Telltale games, so it's totally worth checking out for sure. And again, 4 hours with multiple endings, you can play that game like 20 times in a day probably, and it's just fun.
All right. What about you, Larry? What are you looking forward to? Or anything that you feel like you want to recommend?
No, you know what? I'm totally going to hijack Adrian's thought there. Fucking Shovel Knight, because the new Spectre Knight campaign
yes.
was announced. And I believe spring 2017. And holy fuck, yes. Give me more. More Shovel Knight, more.
And it's Shovel Knight is always good. 2017 is still a little bit down the road, especially spring, but it's Shovel Knight, so it doesn't matter.
It's free DLC, correct?
It is free
DLC.
Yeah.
They've said that they want to do a DLC pack for every one of the boss knights. And they have every intention of issuing them out for free, is what.
No, a part of the original Kickstarter campaign was to release four buses. No, four, three buses as like as a free DLC and playable characters. So the first one was Plague Knight, which we already have. Spectre Knight, which is coming in 2017, and then they're going to be working on, I believe, is King Knight, which is the last one. But it's also going to be free and. It's fantastic. It's people vote on the Kickstarter for which bosses to have as DLC, mm-hmm. and those are the three that won. I will have chose something else, but that's, you know, I didn't know about the Kickstarter, so I didn't have a chance to vote.
Yeah, I like I said, it may not have been in the original. I remember hearing an interview with what's his nuts from Yacht Club Games, though, saying that he would love to do a DLC campaign for every one of them.
It will be fantastic for sure. Like, I would love to play as every single one of the bosses. Even if I have to pay, like, I'm okay with one free DLC. I'll pay for the rest. I don't care. Like, you already gave me more than I was expecting, and I'm okay with giving you more money to give me more. That's fine.
Oh, God, yes.
Yes.
Which, speaking of, by the way, Shovel Knight physical copies for Wii U and 3DS are on sales at the Walmart for $15.
Oh, run and get it now. Run.
$5 bills.
And get it now.
Yes.
Doesn't matter what you do.
That's Tree Fitty.
Download this podcast right now and then take it with you on your car or whatever and get that game. It's a must buy. There's no doubt it's a must buy.
I strongly recommend get the Wii U version so you can grab the Amiibo so you can do co-op.
Yes. All right. Just to give you guys heads up, this is what Nintendo showed and announced. Hollow Knight, Shantae, Half Genie Hero, Jotun, the Valhalla Edition, Steam World Heist, that's available for 3DS and Wii U, Axiom Verge, Fast Racing Neo, Neo Future Pack, which looks amazing. Oh my goodness, that's the new hotness. Like, yes. Get it now. Now, I'm downloading it, like, right after the podcast. That's the game that I'm definitely getting. Dub Wars, Rocket Fist, Zarvot, Ectoplasma, Soul Axiom, Stardew Valley, World to the West, Severed, No Two Love Devolution, which is out now, Antipode DX, which looks like almost an 8-bit Contra game, but deals with gravity. Very awesome game. Forma 8, Guru Man 3D, Rumbo Pocket, Punch Club, and Gun Vault 2, which is coming at the end of this month. So do check out the trailer for those indie games. I think they have Coming Soon and what's going to be released in that particular month. So, man, there's just like so many indie games coming out for Wii U and 3DS. So if you feel like there's not enough games for Nintendo's consoles, the indie got you covered. You know, they are the hotness. They're the new third party kind of for Nintendo until we see whatever's coming for NX. It's about almost 20 some games that's coming out. We already got 5 this month, or 4 this month about to be released. And Gun Vault 2 is the last one for this month coming out. And then we'll just have everything else come out almost every week. And there's also other indie games that they didn't show that you can get on 3DS and Wii U. So do check out the eShop. It's a good time to get great games. And believe me, with the prices that they have for them, it's a really good deal.
Yeah, and you know what? Like, super indie developers, they are starving artists, basically. They make less money, for the most part, than people that take commission on DeviantArt. So, I mean, just go and support them. They deserve it. They make fantastic game, and they'll keep delivering you a fantastic game if you support them. So if you like any like indie game, like go and follow them on Facebook. Go and follow them on Twitter or Instagram or whatever. Share the stuff they make. Tell people about it for sure. Yes. And yeah, like the indie, I think they call it like Nindy Summer Jam or something like that for Nintendo.
Summer Jam.
Yeah, they, Eddie mentioned just like a crap ton of like really cool games that are coming out soon, like either this month or next month or the next couple of months. So for sure, go and check them out. I, for one, am super excited. And I know you mentioned this quickly, but World to the West looks fantastic.
Oh, yes. One of
the 4 gear heroes, and they all have like different abilities. So yeah, go and check the video. We'll post a link somewhere.
Yeah, we'll post the link on the World 1-1 Facebook page, and just so for you guys to check it out.
Be sure to check that out, and of course join the group. So we want to talk to you, and we want to know what you like and what you want us to talk about as well. So
all right, Adrian, I would like to get your point of view. What did you think of the Nintendo Direct for the 3DS? Me and Larry covered it, but want to get your thoughts about it. And also want to get your thoughts about the Sony press conference, if you was able to watch it.
No, I did not watch it. I was traveling, and I missed it. I missed a bunch of stuff.
A fucking thing.
Well, I mean, I'm not that much into the PS4 right now, so mm-hmm. I didn't really care anything they had to show. I think they showed the PS4 Pro or something like that, which is what the Neo was supposed to be. And people are backlashing it for some reason. I don't care enough to check it out, to be honest. So I have nothing to report on that conference front. If I miss anything or if I didn't miss anything, I don't know. Again, I haven't checked it out. I know that the Apple conference, they show Miyamoto was on the stage and they show Mario Run. I'm super excited about that. That's all really I have to say. And for the 3DS Direct, I think it was all right. Mario Maker on 3DS is a fantastic idea, something that I'm really looking forward to getting for sure. And I think that was like my biggest highlight from that Direct. There wasn't – well, Yoshi's Woolly World on 3DS, I think that's also really cool. But other than that, I'm not super hyped about anything else that they show.
What about the amiibo, the Zelda amiibo?
Oh, yeah, but, like, it's amiibo. I'm always going to be crazy about those things.
Okay. Yeah. Any thoughts about Pikmin on for 3DS?
Oh, yeah, that's, like, a 2D side-scroller one.
Yes.
It looks fun. I'm curious to try it out, so hopefully we'll get a demo. Nintendo's been, like, getting better at like throwing demos out there on the eShop, so I'm very interested to give it a try, see how it is. I'm not the biggest Pikmin fan, like I don't have that love for the franchise like most people, mostly because I didn't play it until recently. But yeah, like for those that like Pikmin, I think more Pikmin is better than no Pikmin at all. And for those that are complaining that it's a 2D side scroller and it's not a strategy game, it looked very, very strategy to me from the trailer. So, yeah, I mean, exciting.
All right. Last but not least, what have you guys been playing?
Adrian, you go first.
I got Dragon Quest VII a couple of days ago. I play a little bit of that, like probably like an hour, 2 hours, something like that worth. Not much. I haven't really gotten into the big part of the game yet. But I'm excited to play some more, especially after finishing Chrono Trigger. I was just looking forward to something like this again. Other than that, I've been playing a lot of Rocket League on PC. So if you want to play against me, just send me a private message and I'll add you on the Steam or something and we'll play. Me and my friends are always looking for people to play with. So. Yeah, that's pretty much it, really.
All right. And what about you, Larry? What you been playing?
I've been playing little bits of Axiom Verge at a time because life has drained my ability to focus on anything for more than like an hour at a stretch. So I've been playing Axiom for about an hour at a time, and I'll make maybe about 20 to 30 minutes of honest progress and then wander around going, where the fuck am I going next? And loving every bit of it for that simple fact, you know.
Look, you feel my pain because trust me, I had to look at YouTube and be like, where the heck do I go next?
Yeah, it's not quite as evident as a Metroid game is. It's not quite as fine tuned in that respect, but I mean, you definitely know where they were coming from building this game. I've
played it for a little bit over 2 or 3 hours, I think, and I still don't get why people say this is the best Metroid since Super Metroid. I believe that is a lie, and I love indie games. You all know me. I never lie about that, but I don't think. I mean, this game has the heart of like the original Metroid, but I don't think is better than Super Metroid,
oh, no.
And I don't think it's better than Zero Mission or Fusion, for that matter. So, it's a good game, but it's not better than any of them.
Like
most people are saying right now.
Like Super Metroid is classic. Like that's a game that's so high and on a lot of people's all time favorites. Like that game cannot be touched. Like go ahead, Larry.
I think what they're getting at, you know, by saying that it's the best Metroid, you know, since Metroid, is that, you know, it just in terms of the fact that we haven't had a new, you know, honest Metroid game in, you know, God knows how long at this point, 5-6 years, give or take. And so, you know, what we've had out in the meantime, you know, the other assortment of indie games that have come out in that Metroidvania genre, I think this one definitely stacks up there with some of them. I still think that Shadow Complex was probably the most on-point Metroidvania-style game to come out since Nintendo last put out an honest Metroid game. And I'm saying honest Metroid game because I'm kind of disqualifying Federation Force. Not saying you shouldn't play it, but it's not the Metroid game you're looking for.
Right.
But
the Metroid game we deserve.
Yeah. So, in any case, but it does stack up very well. It's got enough story that I'm digging it, and I don't feel like it's being forced down my throat. It's giving me just enough that I want to know the next part of the story. It's got a fuck ton of weapons in it. Not that all of them are necessarily useful, but they're all there. It's something for you to play with. I am enjoying the upgrades. There are the different environments are growing on me the more time that I spend in them. They don't have that immediate click of, ooh, alien, you know, vegetation alive. It's more like somebody handed H.R. Geiger the rights to make a Metroid game, and he did just that and splashed in a little Contra for good measure. That's what Axiom feels like to me. And I have no qualms with that, but I don't think that it has the immediate charm and uniqueness that the Metroid series does. That's my only qualm with it. It carries it in its own way, but I don't think that it's going to have nearly as much appeal as something like Super Metroid did.
It's a love letter to old school Metroid, like Fast Racing Neo is a love letter to F-Zero GX. It's pretty much the same, but it feels lacking, just like Fast Racing Neo did a little bit. So it's a good game, like it's definitely worth getting it for sure. Again, I've been playing it on PC, so maybe I'm not playing on the best platform. People loved it on PS4. I don't know if there's any difference, but I'll try it again on Wii U for sure.
It's good on every platform. It all controls the same, so you're not really missing nothing.
I think Wii U might be the way to play it, just because you have that sub menu and the giant map, you know, all down on
and the better D-pad.
Well, I've been playing Dust Elysian Tale, almost finished with that. I picked up ReCore for Xbox One. I'm really enjoying that game. I'm still at the beginning, because I kind of want to make sure that I'm doing a lot of stuff right, like exploring the gameplay, making sure that I get a lot of things down with strategies and stuff like that, and doing some kind of side quests and just looking around. Very beautiful game. I am doing a review for it for Team Nerd, so do be on the lookout for that in the coming weeks.
I'll be doing that review and putting it up on our page.
Oh, yes, I sure will. I sure will. trust me, I sure will. But I have to say this. The only problem that I'm having right now is getting the core. So there's a thing called like abstract or something like that, or exhaust or something, extract. That's what it is. And it's kind of like where you kind of throw the rope onto the core, and you gotta kind of press the right button, which is the right directional like analog stick. You gotta kind of hold it down and kind of like almost juggle with it to fish it out of them. It might get easier later on in the game. But that's the only problem that I'm having with it right now. There are some other problems that I'm seeing that I will be talking about. I will be streaming it on my Twitch channel, The Lyrical One, if you guys want to check it out. But it's really good. The control mechanics are fantastic. Great shooting. Just really adventurous. Great puzzles and everything. So be on the lookout for that. But with that, everybody, that is the show. I know it's kind of quick. It's not our long hour discussions. We'll have more about that later on in the coming weeks. But Larry, where can we find you?
Same place you can always find me, sitting on my couch.
Eating a steak.
Oh.
Yeah, giant $50 T-bone steak was the fucking tits, by the way.
Oh, we'll talk about...
Oh my God, it came out on a sizzling plate, and it had melted butter, and it was like an inch and a half thick. It was fucking glorious.
We'll talk about that next episode, so... but we can find you on World 1-1 and on Facebook at Larry I Am Always Right Giver.
Yeah, close enough. Go with that.
So yeah, and you can find his information also on World 1-1 podcast on Facebook. Adrian, where can we find you? What's been up?
You can find me on the nearest sleep deprivation clinic. And you can also find me on thefirstmachine.com, where you can check out what I'm working on, and all the social media where I'm really active, because I'm not active on anything else other than my company's stuff, right? Other than that, join the NBC Video Game Boot Club if you want to play some tech games and discuss them at the end of the month. We're playing Chrono Trigger right now. People are playing Trigger, I really finish it. Recently, I was on Simon's Cave twice, I think, this weekend, discussing both Ultimate Fate and Chrono Trigger. So I'll be sure to check this out as well.
All right, and you guys can find me on Twitter at That Retro Code. You can find me on SoundCloud for Optional Opinion and World 1-1 Podcast. You can find me on Twitch at the, like I said, the Lyrical One, PSN or Comico. I'm doing a blog called The Beauty of Video Games, Volume 2 Genres. This past week, I just did The Beauty of the Sports Genre, and my special guest for the podcast, Mr. John O'Hagan, it's my special guest on it. The following week, the week that you hear this podcast, is The Beauty of Role Playing Games. And my special guest, Adam McGill from DNA DualShock, has joined me. We have a great conversation. So do check out those writings, for that, you can find it at IGN.com under anime, E-N-I-M-E. You can check out all my other writings at digitalnerdadvocates.com and at skirmishfrogs.com. I do a series called The Moment, where I talk about retro games that connect to my personal life. And pretty much, you can find this podcast, like I said, on SoundCloud, on iTunes, Google Play, archive.org, and other podcast apps. And with that, everybody, we are out. Have a great weekend. Have a great week. And we're signing off. Oh, go ahead, Larry.
Listening to our show, show us to your friends so that they can listen too. Maybe eventually we'll get enough people that there will be a conversation on the Facebook page. We do want to talk to the three people that are listening to us. Maybe one day it'll be four. So, share us out with your friends.
Yes. Anything else, Adrian?
No, that's all I have.
Okay.
Share us with your friends and drive them just a little nuts by making them listen to our bullshit.
And with that, everybody, we are out. Bye.
Good night.
Bye.